Good evening, everyone. Good evening, everybody. I'm Pastor Chris Robinson. I am served as the director of DT Preparatory Academy. On behalf of Bishop Charles and Lady Shonda Young, our founders and visionaries for Deliverance Tabernacle Christian Center, I'd like to welcome all of you, particularly our parents and family members, and of course, all of our students back this evening for our Jingle Jam today. Can we just start off by giving Jesus a big hand clap? Now, that make me feel really good if that was for me. But can we give Jesus a big hand clap? Come on. He is the reason. I want everybody to have fun and enjoy yourself. In order for that to happen, students want to make sure, as Principal Vaughn has already instructed you, please stay with your parents this evening. There are a lot of moving people and parts and place and changes that are going to happen throughout the night. You're going to be entertained. You're going to have a great time, but we're going to ask you so that you're properly supervised. Parents, please make sure that your students are with you. If you have to use the bathroom and you're a younger student, so you are third grade or younger, we're going to ask parents if you just accompany them to make sure that we're okay. Make sure that we're okay if that should come up. Throughout the night, if you see something funny, we want you to laugh. If there's music to dance to and you see dancing here, we want you to have a good time and move with it. Who came to have a good time tonight? Oh, I don't know. Let's check this side. Did anybody on this side come to have a good time tonight? That's kind of suspect. What about this side over here? Did this side come? Oh, I think this side came to have a good time tonight. This must be the party side over here. Maybe we just need to warm up. So on this side over here, who came to have a good time tonight? Can we all, let's hear everybody. Did we ever come to have a good time tonight? All right, then, Louis, why don't you go ahead and take it away?
Oh, his mic.
Hello, 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 hello. My name is Louis, and I'm here to introduce you to this outrageous, unpredictable thrill ride that we call Jingle Jam. But before we get started, I think we should play a little game. I might want to start on this side because they said this was the party side over here. Yeah, I might want to start over here, but I want full participation. I need three moms who think they are the straight-up goat of unwrapping presents. I need three moms. Somebody help me out, grab three moms who think they are the straight goat of unwrapping presents. Come on with it. Okay, we got one. All right, we got two. Can I get your name?
Glenda.
We got Miss Glenda. Where your family at?
Right there. Caden Smith and...
Okay, right there. All right. Well, mom number two, what's your name?
Jessica.
Okay, we got Miss Jessica. Where your family at?
Right there.
Okay, they got their hands up right there. Everybody go ahead and clap it up for them. And we got mom number three. I'm going to have you stand behind the box. And what's your name?
Saquana Marshall.
We got Miss Saquana. Where your family at? Somewhere. They see you. All right, so the game is pretty simple. You see, y'all, we got three boxes in front of y'all. The first one to unwrap the box win. That sound pretty simple. That sound pretty simple. But do that sound fun though? How fun is it to see three people just unwrap three Christmas boxes? I think we should add a little twist so they watch we really duke it out. All right, y'all go ahead and bring them out. All right. So what we gonna do, we got one pair of boxing gloves. All right, we gonna have each mom, they gonna place a pair of boxing gloves on. They gotta unwrap the box. We still got a stopwatch back there. So we got a stopwatch. Each one gonna be on the timer. Whoever unwrap their Christmas present first, win. So we got Miss Aquana. All right, so y'all go ahead and clap it up for Miss Aquana before she go.
Sweet
So y'all ready to get ready to unwrap? In 3, 2, 1. She having trouble. She don't know where her family at. Y'all better come help her. That clock ticking, that clock ticking. That clock ticking, come on now. There she go, okay. Okay, she getting it though. We go. 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Y'all still give it up for it though. All right, we ain't even gonna ask for the time on that. We'll wait till everybody else go. We'll get the time on that one. We're gonna switch these gloves up. Hey, it ain't no rules to this. As long as you have your gloves on, however you get that box unwrapped, that's on you. But you got to get it unwrapped the quickest so you win. We got a prize for you. All right. Y'all ready? We good with the stop clock? Let's get ready to unwrap in 3, 2, 1. Let's get it. She used that strategy. Y'all clap it up now, clap it up. Yo, Dennis ain't gonna be happy to see you. Done, we done. Start the clock, start the clock. Alright. Good job. Alright, great job. Alright, that was 32 seconds. So I think that was a little quicker than the first one, but we don't know we're gonna get the times at the end. You said it, not me. You said it.
It was a lot quicker.
Alright, so now we got to get the gloves on you. All right, we got a start clock ready. Ooh, this is fun. Y'all know why we ain't never done this before. So y'all ready? Get ready to unwrap. 3, 2, 1. Using the T strategy too. She gonna make the time though. She gonna make the time when we got 34 seconds to beat. All right, we done. Start the clock, start the clock, start the clock. All right, y'all, we got a winner. We got a winner, we got a winner. She got the box. Oh, hold on. I think it's a crystal vase in here or something.
Oh,
maybe this is why we never done this before. Huh. All right, well, we said we got a winner, so we're going to go ahead. We're going to give her a gift certificate. I believe it's the Applebee's. And let's go ahead and give it up for our winner. We also got something for our other two contestants. Well, we appreciate y'all. Hey, we want full participation all night. Y'all see we got prizes now, right? For sure. So how fun was that? So now y'all ready to get Jingle Jam started? I said, are y'all ready to get Jingle Jam started? Man, I'm going to stay on this left side. They said it was the party side, so I might need to stay. I don't hear y'all too much over here. Are y'all ready to get Jingle Jam started? All right, let's get it.
Where's the song? Thank you. All right, let's go. Let's. You ready? Let's jingle jam. I need some help up here. Come on up. Come on up.
Can you feel it?
Let's go.
Magic Christmas in the air. Moving, moving. Joy is everywhere. Whoa, 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 whoa. Snow is falling down. Say whoa, 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 whoa. Can you hear the sound? Say oh, we're gonna have a party.
I can't really hear you all. Hello, everybody. What you think, Dash? Can we hear?
I think they get louder than that.
I think so, too. Let's try this again. Hello, everybody. Nice, nice. That is much better. All right, so Merry Christmas, everybody, and welcome to Jingle Jam. Yeah, 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 man, we are so, so excited. All right, everybody, listen up. Listen up, listen up. My name is Ginger, and I am your host, and this is my co-host.
Dash.
Yes, Dash. And tell them why we're so excited today.
You know, we're so excited to see all of you here today to celebrate our favorite time of the year.
That's right. You know what? We are so glad that you and your family carved some time out of this busy Christmas season to come spend with us. You know, we have a lot of fun celebrating Christmas. And you know, why wouldn't we? Christmas brings out so much in each and every one of us. It inspires a lot of different things. It can help us see what's important in life. Things like giving to others, showing compassion to those in need, and what else, Dasher?
Putting others before ourselves.
That's right, putting others before ourselves. But you know what? One of the most awesome gifts Christmas brings is something super powerful. Dasher, why don't you tell them, what is this super powerful thing called?
Joy.
Joy. All right, do me a favor, everybody, on your feet. Everybody on your feet. All right, so I need everyone as loud as you can to make a drum roll on your legs. Oh, come on, you can get louder than that. All right, so this is what we're going to do. Keep drumming, keep drumming. We are going to reveal the definition of joy in 3, 2, 1. All right, I need everybody to read this with me. Joy is finding a way to be happy even when things don't go your way. Wait a minute, can we say that again? Joy is finding a way to be happy even when things don't go your way. That's right. You know what? Because sometimes things just don't go our way. You know, sometimes we're supposed to be somewhere and we don't make it. I mean, just things just don't go.
Excuse me. I got a delivery from the North Pole.
Wait a minute. Did you say from the North Pole?
Yep, from the North Pole. Can you please put your thumbprint here for me?
Okay.
Thank you very much.
Wait a minute. Who is this from?
I don't know. It didn't say. But have a Merry Christmas.
Yeah, Merry Christmas. What in the world is this? Okay. Oh, wait a minute. It looks like there's a tag on the side. Hey, Dasher, read that for us.
What's inside is not a toy, but it'll bring you lots of joy. Count from 10 right down to 1, and then get ready for some fun. If surprises aren't for you, well, there's nothing I can do.
Okay, so it looks like we're supposed to count down from 10, and then we get some sort of big surprise that will bring lots of joy. Hey, Joy, we were just talking about that. So, you know, you're going to help me. Can you help me, everybody?
Yeah!
All right, so we are going to count down from 10. Are you ready?
Yeah!
Let's go. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
I think there's something alive in there. Ah! There's definitely something alive in there.
You know what? There is definitely something alive. Wait. We got to be careful. We don't know what's in there. Jinx! Hey, man, what are you doing inside this box?
Bringing joy.
Wait a minute. Wait, did you mail yourself here?
I did.
From the North Pole?
Yep.
Why?
Seemed like a Christmassy thing to do. This was supposed to be Christmassy.
How did you even get, you know, I don't even want to know. Never mind. But how is mailing yourself here from the North Pole in a box Christmassy?
We were supposed to count down from 10.
Okay.
He was gonna pop out the box. He was gonna do a huge backflip over the audience. But I guess it didn't work.
Over this audience?
Over the audience, all the way to the back row. Why are you gonna do it?
Okay, you know what?
Oh well. And then candy canes are gonna come out. We were gonna shoot them all everywhere. The kids are gonna get up. And they were gonna yell. But it didn't happen.
Oh, you know, that really sounds impossible, though.
Nothing is impossible. And then I was gonna shatter the audience with confetti and everything. It was gonna have red and green glitter. Yeah.
You know what? I am so thankful. Aren't you thankful that that didn't work?
I'm really thankful.
And it would have ended all with merriment and joy, but now it doesn't matter. I've ruined Christmas. Christmas is over. This is stupid.
What are you talking about?
I mean, he didn't come out. There's no joy in my surprise not working.
Oh, yeah, you know, he is stuck. But, you know, actually, I think it's pretty perfect. I do.
What are you talking about? I'm telling you, he's stuck in here. There is no surprise, no fun, no joy.
What do you mean?
There's
you know
no
what?
Joy.
But you know what? I'm surprised. Hey, are you surprised that he's in this box? Yeah, you know, we're all surprised. But you know what? That joy part, that's going to be on you. Okay, Trixie?
No. There's no joy.
You know what? Why don't we do Trixie a favor? Let's read the definition of joy one more time. Joy is finding a way to be happy even when things don't go your way.
Well, so you're telling me I need to find joy while Jinx is stuck in this box.
Yeah, that's right. Yep. And you know what? I bet that you can figure out a way in this situation.
Okay, I guess. You know what? I have an idea.
Why don't we get your friend?
My friend?
Yes.
Okay, let me have my friend. Trixie, come on up on stage. Let's show him our great idea we have to get Jinx out of the box.
We're going to get you out of there some kind of way, okay? We just need a little bit of help, okay? All righty. Hey, stagehands, can you bring those buckets out for me? Okay, I need one here. And then let's put one on the other side. All right, so this is what I need. I need two wonderful people to come help out with this little game, because we have to get him out of here. Stagehands, go pick some. We need tall people. We need some. Okay, right here. I need a parent too. Y'all go have a seat. I need a parent. Oh, you're gonna help us out? Okay. All right. You ready? All right. So we are trying really hard to get Jinx out of this box, right?
Yes, definitely. So, you know, we have two boxes here, guys, full of foam peanuts. I have two buckets right here. So my contestants have to try to scoop as many peanuts as they can out of the box into the bin. First person to fill it up to the line wins. Okay? No. Now, here's the trick. I have a bonus for you. I have this wonderful fan here. Everybody see my fan? Things may not always be easy, but hey, it works. It's not gonna work, because she can't get no air. So she got to move, and she has to move. There you go. This should kind of make it difficult for y'all. She's right there, okay? Now, you have to put one hand behind your back. You're gonna scoop with the other hand. All right? Are y'all ready? You ready? You get 60 seconds. 60 seconds on the clock. First person to fill the bin wins. Are you ready? Audience, are y'all ready? Who are you cheering for? You cheering for somebody? Who are you cheering for? All right, let's get it ready. In 3, 2, 1, let it snow. Uh-oh, let's see who's going to get it. Uh-oh. You got to put one hand behind your back. One hand behind your back. One hand behind your back. All right, we got 25 seconds on the clock. You got 25 seconds. Who would be the winner? All right, audience, help me count down when we get to 10. Ready? 10, 9. All right, let's shake it out. Let's see, this is Mrs. Tamaja's bin. Can everybody see her bin? All right, this is for Miss Warren's bin. And congratulations to, you know what, you're great. But congratulations to Miss Sam. She is our winner today. Let's give her a hand. And guess what? Today, Miss Sam will walk away with a wonderful gift of a blender. Congratulations, Miss Sam. Wait. And of course, our loser won't go home empty-handed today. Okay? She will also get a gift. Let's give our contestants a hand, everybody. All right, Trixie, are you ready?
Oh, yeah, I'm ready. You know what? I gotta hand it to you, Trixie. That was a seriously creative way to find joy. It really was. You know, it's something that we can practice all Christmas time. We have all these high expectations of how we want things to go, and then something just doesn't go the way that we want it to. So you know what? This is what we're going to do. We are going to try a little joy practice right now. So I need you to get really close to the people that you came with because I have some questions and I'm going to need some answers. All right, go ahead and give us question number one.
You open a gift expecting something really incredible to be inside, but it's a parasol.
All right, so talk to the people that you came with. How can we find joy when this happens? All right, who's got an answer? How can we find joy when something like this happens? Say it again. Being thankful. Yeah, be thankful anyways. What was that answer? Give it to the homeless?
Being grateful.
Be grateful. That's right. You got to be grateful anyways.
And say that I like my new socks.
Just say, I like my new socks, even if you hate your new socks. Just say you love them. How about a parent? How can we be thankful when something like this happens? Right there, Isaiah. Straight back. There you go.
Be grateful for anything you get because you could be in a worse situation.
Exactly. Be grateful because you could be in another situation. All right, let's look at question number two. Hey, Dasher, go ahead and give him question number two.
You've been practicing really hard for your big role in the school Christmas play, but then you get sick on the day of the performance. How can you find joy?
Okay, how can you find joy when something like this happens?
Have somebody to cover your part.
Yeah, have somebody else do your part. Oh, the baby wanted to talk. How else can we find joy?
Be so thankful.
Be thankful. Be thankful that, you know, God is a healer.
I can still root for my classroom.
What was that? All righty. All right, so let's look at our last question. All right, so you were planning to go to the movie with your friends the day after Christmas, but Mom asked you to stay home and entertain your sticky little finger cousins who break all of your toys. How can you find joy?
Call their mom.
Call their mom? Pick them up.
Bring the party to the house.
Bring the party to the house. Hey, make it a party.
Having fun?
Have fun. Have fun, that's right. Let me get one more.
Eat your cake.
Oh, so there's cake involved now. Okay.
Wait, wait. What? Hold one second. One second. Wait. Did I hear someone ask how we can have joy?
We were just talking about that.
Okay. Well, I've got an answer for you, Dasher and Ginger. Are you ready?
Hey, you know, what are you talking? Wait a minute. Why are you talking like that?
Well, you know, Ginger, have you ever asked yourself, how can I have so much joy when everything is going wrong?
Okay, were you here when we just talked about that? We just talked about that.
You know, Ginger, this is true. This is true.
Okay, I don't know what's so funny.
Okay, well, because today, everyone, I am proud to announce to the public release of this relentless, this unearthed rarity of music.
Oh.
Mm-hmm. And they're Christmas songs before they were classics. Uh-huh. Yeah.
Whoa. Before they were classics, huh?
That is right, Ginger. Now you see why I have so much laughter in my belly. So, you know, not all Christmas classics started out as Christmas classics, right? They have been rewritten over and over and over and over again, all right? But this world album today, Ginger, could be the first draft of all Christmas songs before they were classics.
Okay, well, wait a minute. Before we go there, Mariah Vaughn? Okay, all right. So why would we want to hear any of these songs? I'm just interested in that.
Well, but I am so glad that you asked, Ginger, because this could be your album today.
Today.
For three easy payments of $29.99.
$29.99. Okay, wait a minute, Trixie, that's not what I asked. Wait, is this a commercial?
Of course, glad you said that. This album also includes classics such as the original version of the first Noel entitled More Cowbells. So today, ladies and gentlemen, I have some students here to help me sing our Christmas songs before they were actually classics. Are y'all ready?
More right. Cowbell.
More Cowbell. Come on. Come help me sing this. Are y'all ready? Y'all ready? Let's go, DJ. Let these people hear more cowbell. Told you, Ginger. I think you'll like it.
It's got a nice little tune to it.
Check this out, y'all.
Please, more cowbell. And it's easy to play.
No, stop. What was that?
Ginger, doesn't that just warm your heart? More cowbells?
Okay, no. The song was never about a cowbell.
You know, I really thought you would love it. I did.
What? Really?
Oh, my God, Ginger. Okay, how about the original version of Deck the Halls? You remember that one?
I like Deck the Halls.
Okay, but it's entitled now called Shopping Malls. Everybody love to go shopping? Come on, singers, help me out, and let's show them how it's sung. Christmas songs before they were classics.
Shopping Malls. Shopping malls will be well crowded, fa la 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 la. Credit cards will be maxed out, fa la 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 la. Parking lots will be well crowded, honk 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 honk. All the cars are being crowded, fa la 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 la.
Stop.
That was so wonderful.
Stop. These are horrible songs. Shopping
Listen.
Malls, maxed out credit cards,
oh,
parking lots.
Oh, you're going to love them. Mm-hmm.
No, no. Do you like these songs?
Okay.
I don't either.
All right, right. Okay. How about everybody remembers Jingle Bell?
Yes.
Wait. Here it goes. But did you know the original lyrics to Jingle Bell went something like this?
Stop. Now, that is not Jingle Bells.
Wait, you know what? That is right. You know what? All of these songs could be yours today. These songs. We just saw Three Easy Payments, Ginger, Tell Your Friends, because I guess they don't like my songs, $29.99. Okay? Order now. Guess what, Ginger?
What's the...
You can get a second copy! For the same price. Get yours today. Christmas songs before they were classics today.
Okay. Are you all buying this album? Because if you're not buying the album, I'm not buying the album.
Okay, you know what? How about we fix that? Everybody knows Jingle Bell, right? So how about we sing Jingle Bell? Get up on your feet.
Oh, yes. Wait. The real Jingle Bells?
The real Jingle Bells.
All right,
so I need all my audience to get up on your feet at this very moment, because if you know Jingle Bell, you have to sing it. Are you guys ready?
I'm ready.
Let's sing it. I'm going to have my lyrics back here on the board for those who may not know. Are you ready? Y'all ready? Sing loud.
Let's get through this now. In a one-horse open sleigh, all the really cold, laughing all the way.
Ha, ha, ha.
It's a part of green, making spirits bright. What fun it is to ride and sing and play and love the night.
Oh, jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way.
Y'all sound real good.
What fun it is to ride in a one-horse open sleigh.
Hey!
Jingle bells, jingle all the way.
Yes. Now that
you know what?
Brought you some joy.
That is a classic. But you know what? I really feel like we need a little more joy practice after that.
Maybe so, since you didn't like my classics, but I think, Ginger.
What do you all think? Don't we need just a little more joy practice after that?
Do we need joy practice, everybody? So guess what, Ginger? Since you have the ball, I think it's time for another raffle. Get your tickets out right now. Get your tickets out if you want to win a lovely prize. Get your tickets out.
Hurry.
You want me to pick a number?
Sure, Trixie.
All right, so if you got your tickets, let's see who our lucky winner is today. All right. 565092. 565.
And we have a winner. Come on up.
Woo!
All right, so you have won a 5-piece gift set, Dr. Teals. So enjoy. Thank you for coming.
Give it up for our winner.
All right, so you know what? We're already discovering that you can find joy no matter what the situation is. And you know what? I've got a fantastic game we can play to demonstrate. You know, it may turn out very well, or it may turn out in a way that no one expected. I like to call this game... Box or Unbox. All right, so my stagehands are bringing out my gifts right now. All right. And I need, let's see. I need three parents. I need three parents to come on up.
Hey, how about we get the Grinch up here? We got the Grinch. Okay, well, okay, come on.
All right, so this is how this game goes. First, we have to determine who will go first. So if you can finish my song, then you will be the first person. Are you ready? My song. Okay. Joy to the world. You were first. Okay, all right. So if you all will just take a step to the side for me. All right, so we call this game Box or Unbox. It is pretty simple. Here before us, we have three boxes. We have a small box, medium size, and we have a large box. All you have to do is pick a box. What do you want to take home with you today?
Can I feel them?
You can. You want that one? All right. Why did you pick that one?
It got a little weight on it.
Because it has a little weight. But you know what? Sometimes the biggest present and the heaviest present is not the best present. So I'm going to give you a chance to pick something else. Hey, audience, which one do you think she should pick? This one? This one? They're going with you. But hey, if you pick one of these other boxes, I'll throw in a Santa hat for you.
Look at God.
Okay, so she wants a Santa hat, so we're going to give her the Santa hat. Okay, now this is the best part. You get to pretend it's Christmas, and you unwrap your gift now. Look, she wants the naughty hat. All right, so go ahead and unwrap your gift, and let's see what you have. Oh, she has an iced tea and iced coffee maker. All right, but listen, this is what we're going to do. Here's the twist. If you don't want that, you don't have to take it. If you want to pick a different one, well, no, because I'm telling you that you can make a choice of a different gift if you want. No, they don't get that. All right, so do you think she should keep this one? Well, listen, they said they don't think you should keep this.
Oh, okay. Oh. All right.
But it's up to you. Do you want to keep it or do you want to pick something different? You can keep it. I'm only giving you one chance.
Okay. All right.
Oh, your daughter says you're not going to use it.
We not.
Okay, so do you want to pick a different one?
Yeah.
Okay, what you going to pick? Should she take this one? This one? The choice is yours. Tricked ya. So, do you want that one? I mean, there's one more box up here. Do you want to do that one too? That's fine.
Let's do
that one too. All right, let's see what's in this one. What we got? Oh, okay. A travel mug gift set, Starbucks. What you think? Should she keep this one? Should she keep this one? How about this? No, they're saying no to the last one.
Which one? The first one?
They said no to the coffee maker. So the choice is yours.
All three of them?
No, you can pick which one you want.
Yeah, I'm going to take this.
All right. So let's give her a round of applause, everybody. All right, I need my stagehands. Yes, you may. I need my stagehands to bring out my next set of gifts and come take these away, please. Where are my stagehands? All right. All right, so we are doing a little switcheroo here. All right, so now we have three different gifts, okay? Now, the first gift has nothing, no wrapping paper. It's just a plain box, okay? And then we have a gift that's got some, looks like crumbled up brown paper. And we have this one. I don't know who wrapped this one, but this one has all different wrapping papers ripped up. So do you all know how to play rock, paper, scissors? Okay, we need to do that so we can tell who will be next. All right, you ready? Go. All right, paper covers rock. Okay, so now you get to choose a gift. Which one would you like today? You want this one? All right, are you sure? Because if you change your mind, you get a Santa hat. What's it gonna be? All right, so he's gonna, okay. So it's Christmas today, and you get to unwrap your gift.
Looky,
nice. Looky. It is an anchor glass set. Oh, wow, that's really nice. Can I have it? Can I have it? Not today. Not today. All right, so do you want to keep this, or do you want to try for another one? Okay, I'm only going to let you try for one more. So are you sure? We'll talk about it. Okay. All right, go ahead and unwrap it. Okay. All right, what do we have here? We have a hand mixer. Do you want the hand mixer or you want to stick with your glassware? All righty, give him a round of applause. All right, I need my stockings to come out. All right, you may have a seat. All right, so we're going to do things a little bit different now. We have stockings, okay? And she is not allowed to touch my stockings.
Oh, but they can touch you.
All right, so you get to choose, without looking, which stocking you would like to take. No, you may not touch the stockings. The stockings are special, so you can't touch those. You want this one?
Yeah.
You sure?
Yeah.
Are you absolutely sure?
Yeah.
Okay. All right. So in this stocking, we have a bag. So, well, you know, you got to take this bag, okay, because we played this round a little bit different. So that is yours, and you may open it up. Let's see what you have.
Really?
I mean, I don't know what's in there.
Yeah, this is amazing. I have a sock of coal.
Oh, lumps of coal.
Yeah.
Oh, I'm so sorry. I'm so sorry. But you know what? For being such a great contestant, we're going to throw in the Santa hat.
Oh, that's good. That
okay.
Awesome. I'll take
the coal. Okay. Thank you. Let's give her a round of applause. All right. Well, you know what? That did not turn out the way that I hoped it had. But you know what? Sometimes that happens. Sometimes we hope for all these great things to happen, and then it doesn't. Okay? But you know what? I hope we can find a joy in any circumstance. What you guys think? Should she be grateful for that lump of coal? But Christmas is about joy. Yes, she should. All right. All right, so this year, you know, I wish for all of you and your family to have a perfect Christmas, okay? I hope that everything goes exactly the way that you want it to go. Maybe it will be just like Christmas is supposed to be. Lots of hot chocolate, cozy slippers, houses filled with all these nice aromas. But you know what? Sometimes it may not be that way. But what we are going to do is we are going to present you with a nice little Christmas play. So let's get ready for that.
Joy to the world. Joy to the world. Since the very beginning, when people first chose to turn away from God, the world has been such a dark place. Things fall apart. We all face pain and brokenness, and such terrible things happen. God knew how desperately we needed hope and rescue, and he knew we needed a reason to choose joy. So God planned an incredible gift. He whispered to prophets and poets over hundreds of years ago.
But the very first person to discover that God's gift was coming right now was a girl named Mary. Mary was an ordinary teenager living in an ordinary town of Nazareth in a nowhere special.
And yet, God chose her. He sent an angel with this incredible message.
The Lord has blessed you in a very special way. You will become pregnant and give birth to a son. You must call him Jesus. He will be great and will be called the Son of the Most High God. He will rule forever over his people.
God's son, this ordinary girl, was going to be the mother of God's son. Joy and fear hit her all at once, but she knew this was a gift from God.
But God wasn't sending his gift to Nazareth. He had already promised that his son, the rescuer, would be born in Bethlehem. So some things had to happen for this gift to be delivered in just the right way. A short time before the baby was going to be born, Mary and the man she was engaged to, Joseph, took a road trip.
The Roman ruler Caesar had ordered everyone to return to the place where their family came from so they could be counted.
By the time Mary and Joseph arrived in Bethlehem, the baby was ready to come, but the town was full. Everyone else had to come home to Bethlehem too.
They probably checked with everyone of Joseph's relatives, but no one had any room to spare for them.
Every spot was taken, except it turned out there was a spot, but it wasn't the Hilton or even a decent Airbnb.
The The only available space in Bethlehem was a room they had to share with animals, and that's where God's son was to be born.
God had already made it clear that his gift wasn't just for one or two people, though. That night, he sent another message.
There were shepherds in the field outside Bethlehem. They were watching their sheep all night. Not a panda. I said they were watching their sheep. They were chilling, kind of sleepy, maybe a little bored. When you guessed it, an angel showed up.
Don't be afraid, the angel told them. I got good news that will bring joy to everybody. Today in the town of David, a Savior has been born to you. He is the Messiah, the Lord. You'll know I'm telling the truth, because you'll find a baby wrapped in cloth lying in manger.
And this one angel was joined by an entire choir, and they all sang out, "May glory be given to God in the highest heaven, and may peace be given to those on earth."
Those shepherds jumped right up and ran straight to Bethlehem to see God's gift.
And they weren't the only ones.
God sent the news of his gift far and wide. He posted a notice high up in the sky. A lot of people saw that shining new star, but one group of wise scholars knew it meant something very special. Through study of prophecy, they discovered the star told of a brand new king. These scholars lived far to the east, but they knew to set off on a long journey to Bethlehem, bringing gifts fit for a king.
Do you see it now? God was sending his son as the greatest gift the world has ever seen.
God's gift to the world came in an unexpected packaging. It came to an unexpected place. He brought together the most ragtag mix of people you can imagine. And over time, all of them stood in awe at God's amazing gift, Jesus, God's son.
And this brought so much joy to the world.
So glad it's Christmas.
give it up for our kindergarten and first grade with happy birthday, Jesus. Good job, boys and girls. All right, parents, get your tickets out. I got time for another raffle. Get your tickets out. Come here, KJ.
All right.
Pull a ticket. All right.
What we got here? All right, everybody got your tickets out? Are you ready? All right, so our lucky number is 5, 6, 5, 1, 0. Who we got? 5, 6, 5, 1, 0, 8.
Oh, that's you in the back. Are.
Come on up, come get on your out. Gift. Come on up. We have a nice gift for you tonight. All right.
All right, keep those tickets out. As they're coming down, we're going to pull another ticket, okay? KJ.
All right, what we got?
Merry
All right,
Christmas.
Thank you so much for coming. There you are. Yes.
All right, one more. Number is 5, 6, 5, 0, 8, 4. 5, 6, 5, 0, 8, 4. Is there one?
Who has it?
Is there someone?
Come on, speak up.
5, 0, 5, 5, 6, 5, 0, 8, 4. Is that anybody? No? All right, we'll pull another one.
All right, we're going to pick another ticket. Let's see who has this number. What we got here?
Let's see. 5, 6, 5, 1, 1, 9. 5, 6, 5, 1, 1, 9.
Oh, you're going to miss out on the good one. Oh,
we have a winner.
Here we go. Come on up. All right. Come on up here. We have a nice gift for you. All right. Thank you. Merry Christmas to you. All right. So, God's gift to the entire world was his very own son. This isn't something that we can just put under the tree. This is a gift for the entire world. It's a gift no one expected, given in a way no one expected. And now, because of that gift given to you and to me, we can have joy in all circumstances in ways we would never, ever expect or even understand. Jesus grew up to bring lots of joy to the whole world through his death. First his life, then his death, his resurrection, and his return. Jesus is a gift for every single person in every single place. Across all time. That is why we celebrate, and that is who we celebrate on Christmas. That is why we can take that celebration in every single day of our lives. All right, so I want everybody, this is serious. I need everybody to bow your heads real quick. We're going to say a little prayer. All right. Dear Father, thank you so much for sending your very own son to come and live with us. Thank you that because of Jesus, we have a way to call you our perfect Heavenly Father. We have a way to choose joy no matter what's going on in our lives. Please help us to live out the joy in this Christmas. Help us to know more about this wonderful gift of love you have given to the world. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen. Come on and put your hands together.
Now, you know what, Trixie? That was joyful.
Of course it was. Tongue-tied. You know, you've just brought us another minute closer to the after party where we really get things rocking.
Oh, wow. You know what? I know it's really easy to forget most of your Christmas gifts before the tree is even taken down. But this gift right here, this gift is one that you can open all year long. You can choose joy any day of the year, no matter what's going on in your life.
You know, you're right. You're definitely right. Even when you have to wait for the after party, even when you get your packing peanuts in order, and even when you feel boxed in, see what I did there?
I saw that. Boxed in. All right, so I want to leave you with this last question, and this is the final question. All right. How can you find joy all year long? You know, we're not going to go around the room and take answers right now because you know what? You have all 2020 to talk about it.
Yeah, of course. They have all year. 2020. What's up with that, though? You know, I'm not ready to let go of the teens. Oh, just a little bit. The teens, you know, they've been good to me. 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19. You know, they've been kind of good.
Yeah. But you know what? It's about joy, Trixie.
You're right.
It's about joy.
Age 20 was a good year for me, too, now that I think about it.
You know what? This is what I want you all to do as a family. During this Christmas season, encourage each other throughout the Christmas season and throughout the year of 2020 to find joy, even in difficult moments, like getting up early for school. Or going to work every day.
That is true. But there's one more thing, though. There's definitely one more thing.
What's that, Trixie?
You know, that thing, the thing.
The thing, the thing, the thing. Oh, the thing, the thing.
That thing, yeah.
Okay. All right, so I need my
third
contestant. Who was my third contestant?
Come on back.
Come on back up. I got something for you.
We got something.
All right. So, can you remind everyone what your prize was?
It was a sack full of coal.
A sack full of coal.
A sack full of coal.
Well,
Oh, we didn't even give her a full sack of coal. All right, how did that make you feel?
Kind of like dog.
Yeah.
She found joy even in her coal.
Exactly, and that is what.
There you go.
There you go. So now she can cook hot dogs, hamburger, steaks. All right, so we're good to go. But you know what? I don't want you to go home empty-handed. Okay. So here we have a nice little gift card for you.
Thank you.
And I hope you really find joy in that. All right. All right, so let's give her a hand. All right, so sometimes, like I said, you have to find joy even when things don't go your way.
Okay, yeah. So now we're really ready to take it off, okay? Today we have our eighth grade student here at DTPA by the name of Jada, who is going to give us our closing song of tonight called This Christmas. Clap your hands as she comes.
Hang all the mistletoe, I'm gonna get to know you better this Christmas. And as we trim the tree, how much fun it's gonna be together this Christmas. The fireside is blazing bright, whoa, and we're caroling through the night. outshine the town they do. This Christmas, the fireside is blazing bright, and we're caroling through the night. And this Christmas will be a very special Christmas for me. Whoa. Shake a hand, shake a hand now. Na 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 na.
Stand up and clap your hands.
Come on down, Grinch. Come on down. Our lucky Grinch got a gift today.
565-039.
565-039. Come on down.
Oh, you want to take off on Peanut?
No, don't.
I can't stand. All right, you want to pull another one?
565-112.
565-112. 565-112. Is that you? Is that you? Come on down. How many more we got?
We got one more. Well, no.
This is our, this one here. And we have one more. All right. Last but definitely not least.
565-034.
565-034. Hey, oh, Lauren Chola. I know. 565-034.
Yep. And before we close out, we have one more big gift. We have a Roku TV set. So make sure you have your tickets. And we're going to pull the very, very last one for the Roku.
That is 565-130. That's you?
No.
You got to have it. Go get your ticket. Go get your ticket.
You got 10 seconds.
You got Do our students have tickets too?
There you go.
Congratulations.
All right, parents, we hope you enjoyed our Jingle Jam on tonight. We thank you so much for coming out to celebrate. Tomorrow is an early dismissal day. We'll be dismissing at 11 o'clock. You can feel free to keep your lovely children at home with you and start Christmas break early. Everyone have a great night.
Thank you.